Oh no, that sofa's got to go into the skip.
Down, down, down.
Ha ha ha.
rolling. 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 Stretching his goggles. Stretching. He's going on holiday. Stretching his swimming costume. Stretching. Stretching. Getting bigger. Stretching. Bigger. Whoops. Stretching.
You watched Strictly last night?
Cut, cut, cut. You lot, off. That's not what we rehearsed. Stop the cameras, cut the lights. What are they playing at? That's not the 60s we remember. That's the 60s now. We want the 60s back then. Now, never mind, welcome to the 60s. This is the 60s. Yeah, let's reset, everybody. Thomas, Matthew, let's reset, please.
Yes, that's not a problem.
Right, let's start again, shall we? Hello, and welcome to our guests in Mersey Island, Tattershall Lakes, Wycliffe Bay, Barmouth Bay, and Sandy Balls. It is September the 24th, and I'm your presenter, Vince, and welcome to Ready, Steady, Go!
It was a Memphis!
Welcome to this special edition of Ready, Steady, Go. Now, if you don't know the show, my name is Vince, and each week I bring pop singers down to Studio 9 in Kingsway in London, and also invite you in to join the stars. Now, we're going to kick off with a bit of Nancy Sinatra. A whole host of Beatles hits there. Now, every week on Ready, Steady, Go, we like to take a look at the fashion. So, let's start with hairstyles. Of course, the bob is still there. Hand styles, lots of rings. As for the boots, high heels and Cuban heels are a must. Shirt fronts, immaculately white with long collars. We'll be looking at the fashion next week. Right now, we're gonna take a commercial break. See you soon on Ready, Steady, Go!
Hartley's New Jam.
Hello, I'm Vince from Ready, Steady, Go. Now, if you want to send us a message, it could be a birthday or an anniversary, then text it to this number below, and we'll read them out later on in the show. Hi, it's Vince again from Ready, Steady, Go. Don't forget to send us those text messages on the number below. We'll read them out later in the show.
Enjoying. Someone says to you, this is a genie. You don't come in thinking, yeah, fair enough. You come in suspecting, okay? How can you not realise?
Well, exactly. My point is the fact that you have to find yourself someone really stupid. Do you know what I mean? You'd have to find yourself someone that you think we can dupe this person into believing there's a genie. You know, so either that he's obviously got something where he's into his supernatural stuff and he believes in things like that and ghosts and witches and goblins and elves and all that sort of thing, which some people, there are some people out there, what they called idiots. Yeah. They believe in all that. and you know, it's like, oh, there's an elf. There are real elves. Oh, there's fairies in the garden, you know? Okay. Give them that jacket, the one that does up at the back. That's all I'm saying. Now, I'll be honest with you. Sex education at school was rubbish. It wasn't good. It wasn't as good as it is today. today they do a lot more towards sex education. They also start them a bit younger, I believe, today. Whereas ours, well, I would have been probably about 15 when we had ours. And it was more about don't do it than what to do when you do it. You know what I mean? It was like, don't do it. It's bad. Rah. Your knob will fall off.
Ugh. Well, we were shown A3 colour pictures of STIs. They were passed around the classroom. I almost passed out.
You see, you had that, but in our classroom, the actual STIs were passed around. So that was a difference where we went to school, mate.